Hey everyone. In recent weeks, the news has been dominated by the coronavirus. This rapidly spreading and potentially deadly epidemic has forced a significant shutdown in China. The effects have been felt in the US equity and financial markets as people reacted to the potential economic risks. So, is commercial real estate immune to the coronavirus? Setting aside a worst case pandemic scenario, the effects of the coronavirus in the US have already been felt. The volatility index on the stock market rose significantly. The S&P 500 fell 3.1% between January 17th and January 31st, while the 10-year treasury rate declined from 1.84% to 1.51% over the same span. The rapid rate movements resulted in a very short-lived yield curve inversion as well, potentially signaling an elevated recession risk. But a recession from this is pretty unlikely, given that the very, very brief inversion was really a short-term byproduct of how flat the yield curve has been. Now, most of the near-term impacts appear to be temporary. The stock market has already recovered most of the losses, the yield curve has already normalized, and the 10-year treasury has begun to climb. But some of the effects have yet to ripple through the world economy. The shutdown of factories in China, if extended, could spark shortages of consumer products as well as other materials that are important to the manufacturing supply chain. This could temporarily raise prices on some goods. On the flip side, the price of several commodities have also declined. The price of crude oil is down about 16% since early January. An extended shutdown in China could weigh on global economic growth, but depending on the duration, much of this would be recovered in subsequent quarters. Now, if the coronavirus spreads, the implications could be significant, and a lot of that impact could be driven by what happens in the financial markets. But assuming the coronavirus remains contained, interest rates should stabilize, nudging higher in the coming weeks. Commercial real estate transactions should see little, if any, impact, and real estate performance should remain stable and strong. Only real estate and businesses specifically catering to Asian tourists would be likely to see an impact. Compared to the stock and bond markets, real estate tends to be slower moving, and as a result, it's less volatile. If buyers managed to lock in loans while the interest rates were temporarily down, then they will benefit from a 20 to 30 basis point increased yield. So although there will be some economic ripples that emanate from China and will be felt by the US in the coming months, they should be mild, and real estate specifically will likely see little, if any, impact.